Shadow is spectating me. Now I just need Locke to spectate me, and we're complete. Alright. Not the same person. Arcano Smith seems okay, but I really want Doomsayer, especially going first. Doomsayer on turn 2. It's kind of like having Fiery War Axe against Shaman. Hey Locke, it's 10 AM in Moscow. I haven't slept yet, so it's really nice to see you on stream first time live. Bye, see ya. Alright, thanks Resnick. Thank you for tuning in. Thanks for... it was a good game. And thank you for the sub right away, too. Really appreciate that. Dagger and don't put the poison on, so I can use the poison to combo the Vis. Yeah. Well, no, I should get rid of the Flame Tongue. I was gonna be greedy and play Novice and Vis, but I don't think it's worth it.
Just came back to say goodnight and spy Yobo. Hey, CC! Hope you have a good night.
You missed my comment earlier because the Jay Chou song played and I was like, it's like CC must have requested this, huh? And then I checked it and it was CC. But you did request K-pop earlier too, so you request non-Jay Chou music. Oh, I like this song. Nice agent. Go novice first. If I get Shadow Step, then I'm okay. Yeah. I was gonna say, I'm okay playing Cold Light if I get Shadow Step. Prep Gang Up and then Shadow Step, or do I save Prep for Vanish? I think I need to save Prep for Vanish. That's pretty important, having a really cheap Vanish. Because we can still do Cold Light Gang Up and then Prep Vanish on the next turn. Kemba. Oh, this is really good. I love it when they panic and start throwing all their overload shit out. Seems good. So I hear various like arguments about, oh, do you play Cold Light first or do you prep Vanish first? But I think here Cold Light first is better because I can Cold Light first, gang up, and then prep Vanish, and I still have a Cold Light in my hand after that happens. And I destroy some of the minions because his hand gets full. So I like this. Oh, if I could also drop Doomsayer after, that'd be amazing. That's good, destroys all those. And he's overloaded, his hand is full, we burned a thing from below, which is really important. Those are the hardest things to clear because a lot of times it costs zero mana, so sapping them is not that good. Another cool synergy about Arcano Smith plus Doomsayer is that it's kind of like Nova, it's kind of like Nova Doom in a way. Yeah, I don't think it's worth sapping that. Note to self, listen to more Jay Chou. Why wouldn't people listen to Jay Chou? Actually, just watch CC's stream. It's like Jay Chou a lot of times. Did we get a shout out for CC already? I think I did earlier. We're gonna do Brand Cold Light. Brand Cold Light into Sap the Fire Ellie. That kills the Fire Ellie. It's that's not half bad. We got another cool light. We can even clear this guy. Do I want to play Doomsayer? Well, it's like kind of nice if I can keep Rand alive. So if I just sap this. I want to keep prep for the Vanish, so yeah, we can get rid of this guy. At least that way there's a taunt in the way of Rand. Pretty sure he really misses that Manatide. He's like, oh damn, why'd Manatide get milled? Oh, thanks Yobo. Seems good doing some mod work. If you try to Shadow Strike, I was finding Poison to be a bit harsh on my health total. It's so expensive, that's the thing. Yeah, you're right. I've seen some Beastlists that run 2 Shadow Strikes and he's not running Novice, but mine is just faster cycle then. Those are pretty shitty one drops. Play another Feral Spirit. Panic. Texas Afterthought. Do they even care about this stuff? Only if he has Bloodlust. So draw first. I can prep Vanish and clear the board. If I think the board's a threat. Which I don't think it really is. Just saving that prep vanish.
Hey, D-Lighting, good to see you. Yeah, sweet dreams, CC.
What's he gonna do? Bloodlust? Please don't hit my face. Please just kill a minion. 50-50 still. It's probably still not a big deal if it hits my face. I'm still at 8 health. But yeah, it's definitely way nicer that it doesn't do that. So I do prep. I do prep, cold light, vanish. Yeah, prep, cold light, vanish. And that clears the whole board. Or I don't have to do that and just. Like, are we close to killing him? That's probably okay. Prep Cold Light Vanish, and then I can still drop a Doomsayer to prevent him from playing anything. I need to drop double Doomsayer. That's probably smart, because then he can't hex both. He can only hex one of them. So let's make sure that he absolutely can't play anything this turn. Because I think I only need one more turn to kill him. Like, one more turn not to die, and then he has no chargers.
Oh, thanks D-Lighting. I'm glad to be streaming too. Gonna lurk, probably go to sleep soon. Alright, Agent. Hope you get to celebrate you getting a job soon.
Yeah, I should hear back next week, I think. The hiring manager is out of town this week, so he said he's not gonna be able to get back to me this week. But I have another interview on Friday.
Yeah, thank you, Adrian.
Fire Ellie the face. Lightning bolt. So both Fire Ellies are gone, both Lightning Bolts are gone. I think that's all his direct damage. Even Alakir, I mean, they're not running Rockbiters anymore. And plus, he's overloaded, so you can't even do Alakir Rockbiter. So we play Cold Light into Gang Up into,
Almost out of cards.
He's just trying to make sure when I mill myself, when I start milling, that I die. So he's just trying to set my life total low, I guess. But to be safe, we can get Arcano Smith down. That's fine. So yeah, even Alakir doesn't do anything. We're out of song requests too. But that's okay. I'll play some of my stuff. Or we can go back to the YouTube playlist I was playing, which is pretty easy. It took two, right? So Puffin subs. It's not Puffin, it's a Hoppy. No Rogue is more entertaining to watch. Yeah, I think it's pretty fun. It's not great for ladder climbing. One is, it has some bad matchups. Two is it takes a long time for the games. It's kind of like how Control Warrior or Freeze Mage also take a while, but at least Freeze Mage has a pretty solid win rate against most of the meta. The fun thing about No Rogue is even if it's a favorable matchup for you, say it's against Control Warrior or it's against Murloc Kali or Priest, you still have to play it very well. You can't just autopilot and win the game. Like you still have to think about every turn. And that's what I like about the deck.